Hey there, this is John from Heroes and Legends. During this difficult and trying time, we need to come together by staying apart. We all need to do our part to flatten the curve and save lives. Stay isolated and continue to social distance, wash your hands frequently and effectively, and help spread the word to others who don't understand how they can make a difference. Finally, I'd like to thank the real heroes and legends out there, everyone whose jobs are essential and are working hard every day for all of us. To find out more on how you can stay safe and make a difference, check out the World Health Organization's website at www.who.int. Hey there, this is John from Heroes and Legends, and welcome to the second day of Ikoria Previews. There are a ton of cards to talk about today. Over 60 in today's video, so I'm going to go kind of quickly, not go into as much detail as I normally do in these videos, just so we can get through it all today. Couple things before we get started. One, if you're curious as to the sources of any of these cards, check out the description below. Anything that did not come directly from Wizards, you can find out which content creator previewed which card there. And also, if you go to flipsidegaming.com, you can still use the Heroes promo code to save 10% on any order over $10. But they are closed right now, so their orders are not shipping out. I just wanted to make everyone aware of that. All right, without any further ado, let's get into it. All right, we're going to begin by looking at some cards we talked about yesterday, but we got to look at some different variations of those cards. So quickly on the screen, if you want to hear my thoughts on these cards, check out yesterday's video. But you see here King Caesar, Ancient Guardian. That's the Godzilla frame. You have the regular frame for Gemraiser as well as the Showcase Gemraiser frame. And then in the end there, you see a promo pack copy of Sprite Dragon. All right, just one Commander 2020 card to talk about before we get into the Ikoria cards today. It's Arcane Signet. Great reprint. You're going to get a copy of this in each of the Commander 2020 decks. All right, on to Ikoria with Mysterious Egg. On the left, you see the regular copy. On the right, you see the Godzilla variation. But this is one of those Godzilla cards that's only in Japanese that we talked about yesterday. If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out yesterday's video. It's a long story, but not a lot to say about this one. Good limited common for a mutate strategy. Next is Draneth, Magistrate. This is a card that might see some limited play, like out of the sideboard against Companion. Could even see some standard sideboard play, potentially. But this is going to be a Commander staple for White. For Commander or Brawl players, this stops your opponents from playing their Commander out of the command zone. Flourishing Fox is next. Nothing crazy here, but a good card if you have a lot of cycling in your Drafter Sealed build. Mythos of Snapdax. This is actually pretty sweet, and I do like the fact cards are sacrificed here. Obviously, this is better if you're in Mardu colors, and I do think in Mardu decks, perhaps in Standard, this might see a little play. Savai Sabretooth. This is okay in Limited. It's not always going to make your cut, though. 3-1s for 2 sometimes are nice if your opponent stumbles, but ones that don't have abilities on them don't seem all that exciting to me anymore. Next, we have a Chinese traditional preview. All these cards that are translated, these titles especially, are loosely translated. But this is a cool combat trick for a limited. I especially like the fact that it has cycling. Valiant Rescuer. This is going to be a good addition to your build in Drafter Sealed if you have a lot of cycling cards. Could there be a cycling deck in Standard? I haven't seen enough cards yet to make me feel like it's going to be a thing. But there's still a lot of cards left to see, so you never know. Archipelagore. I like the name of this card. Pretty cool mutate ability. It's going to help you in Drafter Sealed get past some board stalls from time to time. Next is Boon of the Wishgiver. Solid limited draw spell with cycling. So if you stumble and can't get up to 6 mana in a timely manner, you can always cycle it away for just 1. Dreamtail Heron. This is a great mutate ability for limited, and it has Flying to boot, which is going to be nice with that mechanic in general. This one's an Italian language preview. It's Keep Safe, and I do think this is a little too narrow for Standard. However, depending on where the meta goes, this maybe could see a little play out of sideboards, perhaps. When it comes to Limited, though, I think this is a better card there. I like the fact that it does cantrip, and it only costs a blue and 1. Another counterspell would neutralize. I think Sinister Sabotage is still better, but I like having cycling on this. I would definitely play this in Limited in the right deck. Phase Dolphin, good to get past board stalls and limited, especially good in this set. Reconnaissance Mission, okay, Coastal Piracy is cycling now apparently, and I really like that on this card for Drafter Sealed. Many times you could be in a situation when you draw this, you could be behind, and if you are, this is not going to feel like a great draw. Now, if things are even or you're a little bit ahead, that's where the card would really excel. But because it has cycling now, if you are behind, it does let you toss it back and hopefully hit something that's going to be a little more helpful like a removal spell or maybe even a board sweep, something like that. So that flexibility makes this card that much better. Next is Voracious Great Shark. On the left side, you have the regular copy, but it is a Chinese simplified copy. On the right side, you have the extended art copy, but that one is in English. Not too much else to say about it, though. It's a solid limited card, and it has great flavor. Wingfold Terran. So this looks a little expensive at first, even for Drafter Sealed. But remember, with Mutate in the set, that Hexproof counter could come in really handy. Blood Curdle. Now, this is going to be premium removal in Drafter Sealed for you. It's splashable, it costs 4, it's at instant speed. This is going to be a high draft pick, as a matter of fact, maybe first pickable in some packs. This gets even better in an aggressive build like Rakdos, for example, where that Menace counter could really mean something. Call of the Death Dweller. Okay, I like cards like this in Limited. I try to play them whenever I can. This one costs 3, especially in this set with cycling. You might be able to cycle some creatures and then get them back later, which is kind of nice. And also, too, those counters could be consequential later in the game as well. Cavern Whisper, good limited card, has a relevant ability and a mutate trigger. Chittering Harvester, another decent limited mutate creature here at Uncommon. Next is Dirge Bat. This is a good rare mutate card for limited. You're not always going to get your hands on it, but this could be a card that pushes you in that direction, perhaps. What I like about this more than anything is the fact that it has flash. And on your right side, you see the Japanese-only Godzilla variation. Next, we have a German language preview extinction event, and you can build around this, but it still feels a little high variance for me if I'm thinking like standard or something like that, especially considering the casting cost, knowing that the variance is involved. Beyond that, though, unlimited, yeah, you know what? I would probably run this as a panic button, and hopefully it will just work out if the time comes. Insatiable Hemophage. Here's a more mid-rangey creature for those mutate decks. We've seen a lot of expensive ones over the last couple days. We'll see a few other mid-range or cheaper ones later in the video too, but you will need to have a good curve if you're trying to build around this mechanic, and a card like this could help you. Mythos of Nethroi. Check out that Seb McKinnon art. Always killing it. This is a really good card too on top of that. Awesome removal spell, even if you don't have ops on colors. If you do, even better. This will see standard play. Next one is a French language preview, and you see the translation on the left. It's Unbreakable Bond. These cards are always good in limited. I think especially though in this set, this could be really good because you might be able to cheat some big creatures into play out of the graveyard, especially if you can mill yourself or just get things into the graveyard somehow. One way to do that would be cycling. That feels like it would be a pretty legitimate option so far in the limited games. And on top of that, the lifelink is a nice bonus as well. Next is an Italian language preview, Clash of Titans. And yeah, this is a good limited card. Remember, you don't need to fight with your own creature. This just says two target creatures fight. You could sometimes take out two of your opponent's creatures with this if all goes well. Ultimately, yeah, I'll run one of these and be pretty happy with it. Everquill Phoenix. And again, you see all three copies of the card that are out there. This is interesting because it says target Phoenix on it. I thought that was kind of cool. It really wants to come into play for the mutate cost whenever possible, so it does want other persistent creatures around it. Maybe some other Phoenixes. Could there be an Arclight Phoenix deck returning to standard with a card like this? We saw a decent card yesterday too that could play along with that concept. Maybe, it might still be a long shot, but a card like this does bring us a little closer, I think. This will be great and limited, obviously, regardless though. Mythos of Vadrok. I'm not as high on this one as some of the other Mythoses we've already seen. Sorcery Speed does hurt this. I think I like Storm's Wrath better in standard, but this is a good limited card though. Shredded Sails. This has great versatility. It feels like a charm in a lot of ways. I could see this in standard coming out of some sideboards at some point. In limited, you could even main deck this because of the cycling. Yadaro, Wandering Monster. Again, you got the complete suite of different versions of the card there. This one is really, really good. This one could be a sleeper hit. Let's talk limited first. Yeah, play the card if you're lucky enough to get this rare. It's going to cost you 7, and hopefully you can just get an 8-8 trample haste creature into play and call it a day. Now, if you can, if you stumble, you can cycle it. Wonderful. Standard, I think this could see play there. I'm thinking maybe it's Magical Christmas Land, but I want to see like an Is It Control Shell running 4 copies of this with lots of card draw, lots of dig, try to get these things out as soon as possible for the cheapest possible cost while you're controlling everything else. Feels like it could be interesting and maybe even possible. Remember too, if you cycle the card and it goes into play off that cycling, that's something that your opponent can't just counter, which is kind of nice as well. Maybe this could even see some Pioneer play under some circumstances. I could be going a little deep with this card, but I do think it has a good chance at doing something. Auspicious Staryx, you got a couple different versions of the card on the screen there. This is going to be an amazing limited uncommon. It's got great stats. Even if the creature may feel a little smaller in the set compared to others, it's still pretty economical for what you're paying for it, and you have the possibility of hitting some big things off the top of your deck. This could be a good Brawl and Commander card too. Here's a Spanish language preview, Barrier Breach, and I like this card for sideboards and Standard, maybe even Pioneer. If the metas need something to deal with enchantments, the cycling really pushes this type of card, and in Limited, I don't necessarily want to main deck this, but I'll be happy it's in my sideboard if I need it. This one's a Russian language preview, Charge of the Forever Beast. This is nice limited removal, nothing crazy here, but definitely playable. Sorcery speed, sure. Also requires you to have a big enough creature in your hand, but it only costs 3. Colossification, there's that big aura that was promised. On the left you see the regular copy, on the right you see the bundle promo foil copy, which will be packaged into the bundles. Now for the card itself, this is going to be awesome in Commander. There's like a million different things you can do with it. You can probably list a bunch off the top of your head right now. This will see a lot of Commander play. It will be good in Brawl too, obviously. Now, Limited, yeah, this is going to be fantastic there too. I mean, I don't think 7 in this set is too much to ask. Sure, you're opening yourself up for a 2-for-1, but maybe you play this after you attack when your creature's already tapped. That's going to mitigate the drawback a little bit. And then your opponent is going to need to find an answer, especially if the creature you put it on has Trample. They need an answer right then and there. Even if it doesn't have Trample, it's still going to be pretty persistent and pretty annoying to deal with, even if they can chump it a few times. And don't forget, if you just need to swing in for like lethal damage, you can put this on an opponent's creature to tap it down and then attack in. Fertilid, this one's a reprint, good mana fixing card for Limited, not much else to say about it, you may have played with it before in the past. Adding counters to this can be fun too. Glowstone Recluse, couple different copies of the card there. Another cheaper mutate creature, which is nice to see again for that Limited curve. Kogla the Titan Ape, I love this card, I love the flavor and the top-down design, obviously reminiscent of King Kong. Now, the card itself, first off in Limited, it's going to be a great rare, no surprise there. It does a lot for the mana you're putting into it. Maybe this could see some Standard play, perhaps in some kind of ramp build with cards like Charming Prince and Lovestruck Beast. Migration Path. Okay, so Explosive Vegetation now has cycling, apparently. And again, it just makes that type of card that much better. This is going to be a great limited uncommon in this set, especially where you're trying to get up to a lot of mana quickly as possible. This will also be awesome in Commander and Brawl. This one's a Portuguese language preview, Monstrous Step, and this isn't thrilling to me. It has cycling, so that's going to help me at least consider playing it some of the time in Draft or Sealed, but it is sorcery speed. It's not a real combat trick. It is nice if you're just trying to get rid of an untapped creature that's on the battlefield and you have a creature that you can put this on and attack in for the turn. Wonderful, but that's a very specific circumstance. If they don't have a blocker, then you could end the game earlier, but you were probably already winning anyway at that point. Which again, the cycling kind of helps me feel better about this card, but I still don't think it's always going to make my cut. Next we have another Portuguese language preview, it is Wilt, and yes, now Naturalize has cycling too, because why not? So yeah, I do think this could see some Standard sideboard play, and this will be good for you in Limited out of the sideboard too when you need it. Back for more! Okay, Golgari colors in this set do appear to really care about things in the graveyard, so this is going to fit in very well in that strategy. Awesome limited uncommon, and it's an instant, perfect for these colors, but just generally a good card. Channeled Force, there's Narset in the art there too. Could this be one of the cards that helps that Standard turtle deck get to their turtles? I don't know, maybe. But it is a good limited card if nothing else. You are going to be able to get rid of some cards that aren't helpful, like if you draw extra lands or something like that. Draw more cards, hopefully hit some heat, and also maybe even be able to deal with something on the battlefield. Cheville, Bane of Monsters. Okay, this one's a mythic. You won't see it all the time. If you happen to get it in Limited, though, it could be very good for you. But here's what I'm really excited about. Commander players? Finally, Bounty Hunter has a card to combo with in Commander. So yeah, you could definitely play this with Bounty Hunter. That's something. Other than that, though, this is a cheap card that could be really annoying early on in the game. And because of that, maybe it does have a chance to see Standard play. Death's Oasis. A couple different copies of the card there. This seems a little bit slow and conditional, even for Draft or Sealed, but if you're in a mostly Golgari with a splash of white and you care about things in the graveyard, then maybe it's playable. It's going to be a very specific type of deck that wants this, though. Beyond that, the gain life ability at the bottom maybe could be relevant some of the time, considering the set has a lot of big creatures. Dire Tactics. Now, this card is really good. I could see this going into, like, Pioneer Hero right away. This will see Pioneer play. It will see Standard play. Awesome limited removal, too, at Uncommon. General Kudrow of Dranith. Another Mythic Rare here. You're not going to see it all the time in Draft or Sealed, but it has good stats if you happen to play with it, especially if you have some other humans in your deck. Now, maybe this could actually see a little constructive play, perhaps like Modern Humans out of the sideboard. I'd at least want to try it out there. And who knows, maybe down the road there could be a Humans deck in Standard at some point. General's Enforcer. This feels like one of the Signpost Uncommons here, this time for Orzhov colors. Legendary Humans you control have Indestructible, so that's going to play really well with the General we just saw a moment ago. Now, the other ability might be more relevant in Draft and Sealed, being able to keep your opponent's graveyard under control. And you also might be able to build up your board state a little bit to boot. Could be pretty good, considering what you're paying for this card. It also has nice stats, 2-3 for 2, even though it is two different colors. Labyrinth Raptor. We have another Signpost card here, this time for Rakdos. And if you haven't noticed yet, it looks like Rakdos wants to be pretty aggressive, pretty liberal use of menace in this set. And this is going to fit perfectly into that strategy, especially for your draft builds. Now, aside from that, could this see Standard play? Maybe in an aggressive deck. This is a pretty aggressive creature. And who knows, maybe we'll see some kind of Standard Menace Tribal build. That would be pretty sweet. Nethroi, Apex of Death. You get the complete complement of different card types on the screen there. Now, the mutate ability here is nuts. This is going to be fantastic in Commander. Considering the cost, Commander or Brawl, I think, is where this is going to excel the most. Still a limited bomb, though, if you're lucky enough to open it. Primal Apathy. I think this is going to be nice Commander and Brawl value for 3 here. In Limited, sure, it slows you down a little bit to play it, but most of the time I think it's going to be worth it. Another Portuguese language preview here. This time we have Quartz Forest Crusher. So we talked about some Menace Tribal. How about some Trample Tribal? I think a lot of Commander decks would like this, especially if they have a lot of Trample creatures. Notice this is also a dinosaur, and it's a beast, so it definitely fits in with those creature types. Maybe at times it's a little bit of a win more in Limited, but you're going to be happy to play with this if you get your hands on it. Skull Prophet, here's your limited Signpost card for the Golgari colors. As you can see, Golgari wants to populate the graveyard. You also get a little ramp here, which is pretty nice, and if your opponent stumbles, it's a 3-1, you could get some damage across too. Trumpeting Gnar, maybe this one's the Signpost card. It doesn't cost just the green and blue, it costs green, blue, and 1. It seems like the Signpost cards have just been the two colors, but this one could be an exception. Another cheaper card with Mutate for your curve and Limited. Fiend Artisan. This one's a Mythic, but this one could be really good. It is conditional on board state, sure. And the ability needs to tap, so it's not going to just take off right away. But in the right build, this could grow quickly, and it is comparable to Birthing Pod or Vanifar. I do think this could see play in Standard, maybe even Pioneer. Being a Mythic, it's good in Limited too, as you would imagine, if you can get your hands on it. This one's a Spanish language preview. It's Obosh the Burrower. I like this one a lot too. This card is maybe my favorite of the companion cards so far. Even if you don't use the companion ability and it's just in your deck, it could be quite good. I like the fact that it's whenever a source you control with an odd converted mana cost deals damage, not just like a creature in combat or something like that. So it does open it up to a lot of different possibilities. And if you're drafting and get this early, you could try to draft around the stipulation a little bit. And again, even if it's not your companion, it still could be a very, very solid card for you. Commander and Brawl decks too. If you can just build around the stipulation, this card could be excellent there. Maybe even a Standard deck out there could want something like this. We'll have to kind of see where the meta goes. Proud Wild Bonder, good limited card. Again, another one that kind of alludes to the idea of Trample Tribal, which might be fun to try to build and draft. Also, Commander and Brawl decks, if you want to go all in on Trample, this would be a good card to include. Crystalline Giant is next, and again, you have a card with the full complement of different copies, including the Japanese-only Godzilla copy that you see on the right side there. I do think this is a little too high variance for Standard since you don't know what ability you're going to get, although if it stays alive long enough, it is going to become pretty hard to deal with. But I do think this is a good limited rare if you're lucky enough to get it, and it could be fun in Commander or Brawl too. Indatha Crystal, we have a whole cycle of these. We're going to look at the other four in just a second. But obviously, you may have noticed at this point that there is a wedge theme in this set. It's not the main theme, but there are definitely reasons you might be interested in playing the wedge colors in Draft or Sealed. These are going to be great in limited games to help you fix or ramp when you need to. You might not always need to, but it has cycling, so it does mitigate the risk of just getting this when you don't need it, which is really nice. The more cards that have cycling, the happier I am. I think it's a fantastic mechanic. These will also be nice additions to Commander or Brawl decks. Let's take a look at the other four. Kutraya Crystal? Raugrin Crystal? Savai Crystal? And Zagoth Crystal. Alright, that does it for today's cards. Wow. I'm sure more have come out since I've recorded the video, but we're just going to have to pick those up later in the weekend. Tomorrow, we're going to come back and do our Market Watch video as we always do. Then later in the weekend, we're going to try to catch up on the card previews that are coming out. There's a lot of them. This is a very hectic week. I like to typically talk more about these cards and like different places you might be able to play them and stuff, but it's just not possible, unfortunately, with the amount of cards coming out so quickly. So at least with these videos, though, you know you're not missing anything. We're going to at least quickly cover all the cards that come out. Until next time, though, hey, thanks for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe and have a great day.
Hey, thanks for watching. This video is made possible through the generous support of viewers like you on Patreon. Check out the description below for links to our Patreon page as well as our Amazon affiliate store, where a small percentage of all sales will also help support the channel. Finally, if you haven't had a chance yet to subscribe, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of the new videos on Heroes and Legends. Talk to you again soon, and have a great day.